Concord, NH. An off-the-grid New Hampshire man's days living as a hermit appear to be over. River Dave, whose cabin in the woods burned down after nearly 3 decades on property that he was ordered to leave, says he doesn't think he can return to his lifestyle. I don't see how I can go back to being a hermit because society is not going to allow it, David Lidston said in an interview with the Associated Press on Tuesday. Lidston, 81, said even if he could rebuild his cabin, which burned down last week, I would have people coming every weekend, so I just can't get out of society anymore. I've hidden too many years and I've built relationships, and those relationships have continued to expand. Lidston, a logger by trade who chopped his firewood and grew his food in the woods, initially built the cabin with his wife, from whom he is now estranged, although he said they are still married. He said he's not grieving the loss of his life in isolation. Maybe the things I've been trying to avoid are the things that I really need in life, said Lidston, who drifted apart from his family. I grew up never being hugged or kissed, or any close contact. I had somebody ask me once, about my wife, did you really love her? And the question kind of shocked me for a second. I've never loved anybody in my life. And I shocked myself because I hadn't realized that. And that's why I was a hermit. Now I can see love being expressed that I never had before. Lidston declined to comment further on his relationship with his family. Two of his 3 sons had told the app they hadn't been in touch with their father recently, and his daughter did not respond to a message seeking comment. On July 15, Lidston was jailed on a civil contempt sanction and was told he'd be released if he agreed to leave the cabin following a property dispute that goes back to 2016. The landowner, 86-year-old Leonard Giles, of South Burlington, Vermont, wanted Lidston off the property. The property, undeveloped and mostly used for timber harvests, has been owned by the same family since 1963. Lidston had said a prior owner in the family gave his word years ago that he could live there, but had nothing in writing. He later disputed that he was even on the property. In court Wednesday, both sides agreed to arrange for Lidston to collect his cats and chickens and remaining possessions at the site. Some items had been given to police for safekeeping. Lidston, who still believes he was not on Giles's land, also was given permission to hire a surveyor to give him peace of mind, Judge Andrew Schulman said. A fire destroyed the cabin on August 4, hours after Lidston defended himself during a court hearing. He was released from jail the next day after the judge ruled that he would have less incentive to return to this particular place in the woods, now that the cabin had burned down.